In this video, we find out how to stream games from your computer to your Raspberry Pi using Steam Link. The Steam Link app is the software version of the Steam Link, which was discontinued a couple of years ago. It allows you to play Steam games across multiple devices as long as you've got Steam installed on one of your computers, and it's available on a bunch of platforms, including the Raspberry Pi. Nice. Better yet, the setup is incredibly straightforward. But before we get on with this tutorial, we'd like to thank JLC PCB for sponsoring this video. JLC PCB provides fast PCB prototype and SMT assembly services at high quality and affordable prices. You can currently get free SMT assembly coupons when you place an order on their website. Click on the link in the description to find out more. Right, so for this tutorial, you'll need a Raspberry Pi, a microSD card, a card reader, and your standard input peripherals, or maybe even a gaming controller if you'd prefer to use that to play games. We'd also recommend using an Ethernet cable over Wi-Fi to connect to your network for this project. Otherwise, the performance may feel a little bit underwhelming. If your microSD card is already preloaded with Raspberry Pi OS, you can skip to the timestamp shown on the screen. If not, we'll go over that now. First things first, we'll use Raspberry Pi Imager as our image writing tool, as it's convenient for Raspberry Pi OS. The link will be in the description. With your microSD card connected to your computer via the card reader and Raspberry Pi Imager installed and opened, click on Choose OS and select Raspberry Pi OS, which should be the first option in the list. Then, select your SD card and start the writing process. This might take a while. Once that's done, plug your microSD card into your Raspberry Pi and let's fire it up. We should be greeted with the Raspberry Pi OS setup. Click on Next. You can change the language and time zone settings here if you'd like. Next, the default password is Raspberry. Although we didn't change it here, it's probably a good idea to do so. As you can see, we've got this annoying black border around the screen. Go ahead and tick this box if you've got this issue as well, and it should be fixed on the next startup. We'll connect to our Wi-Fi network in this case, but again, we recommend using Ethernet instead for this tutorial. You'll get much better performance. Finally, you'll be prompted to update the Raspberry Pi. Okay, next. With the update complete, we can restart the Raspberry Pi and move on to the installation of Steam Link. First of all, open up a new terminal, and let's make sure that our packages are up to date by running this command. Once that's done, we can install Steam Link like so. To launch it, type in Steam Link and press Enter. Now, as this is the first startup, it will download the appropriate latest version of Steam Link for the Raspberry Pi. While it does that, please leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying it. That would be much appreciated. Do we want to install the additional packages? Yes, we do. So type in Y and press Enter. And once again, Enter. And one more time, press Enter to start Steam Link. We're almost done with the setup. All we need to do now is to connect it to our computer. Welcome to Steam Link. Thank you very much. Let's get started. We don't have a controller, so we'll skip this step, but feel free to connect yours if you'd like to. Okay, we're almost there. On this screen, you should see a list of computers that are currently running Steam in your network. If you can't see your computer, make sure that Remote Play is enabled. To do this, click on Steam and in the settings, select the Remote Play tab and ensure that Enable Remote Play is checked. Click OK and back on your Raspberry Pi, click Rescan. Select your computer and you should see a 4-digit authentication code on your screen. you should also see a dialog box pop up on your computer. Enter that code there and click OK. Next, it's going to perform a network test. And because we're using Wi-Fi, we're limited to only 5 megabits per second, which is pretty poor to be honest. So we can't stress enough how important it is to use an Ethernet connection, as the Raspberry Pi 4's Wi-Fi performance isn't that great. But anyway, hit start playing, and we're in. This is essentially Steam's big picture mode being streamed directly from your computer to your Raspberry Pi. So go ahead, knock yourself out, enjoy your games, and when you're done, you can stop streaming by holding the escape key for a couple of seconds and selecting stop streaming. And hit escape once again to exit Steam Link. You'll notice that the Steam Link shortcut has been added to the desktop, so you can simply open it from there. But if you're planning on using your Raspberry Pi as a dedicated Steam Link device, you might want to launch the app automatically on startup. So let's go ahead and do that before we wrap up this video. Let's open up our terminal once again, and run this command to edit the auto start file. Add this line to the bottom of the file, and save the changes by pressing Ctrl and X, followed by Y and Enter. Reboot the Raspberry Pi. And sure enough, Steam Link starts up automatically. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. We hope you found this useful, and as always, don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe for more content like this. Also, let us know what else you'd like to see in the comment section below, and we'll see you soon.